Welcome back to the fifth session of history. In this session, I'll be talking about the Indus Valley Civilization part 2. Prior to this, we have seen to it that which were the important cities in a graphical manner. In this part, we'll be looking forward toward the important city of Indus Valley Civilization in detail, and we'll be discussing one-to-one on them as per being asked in various exams, such as UPSC Civil Services, State Civil Services, and SSC Banking, etc. So, for the very first site coming up with me, Abhinav Sharma from Shabir Gavir, right? So, let's start it up. The very first city of the notable city of Indus Valley Civilization being Harappa. Now, as we have discussed this earlier in the previous session, that it was excavated in 1921 by Dayaram Sahani. It was and it is on the banks of river Ravi under John Marshall, right? So John Marshall being the new Director General of Archaeological Survey of India, which was now set up in 1920 as an independent charge it had. So the first city which was excavated was, complete city that was excavated was Harappa, and for the same, Harappa was also the first site which was discovered, right? For the same, it is also known as Harappan Valley Civilization. Now, also, it is the largest city, one of the largest cities being discovered in the entire IVC module, and it is in Mint Gumli district of Pakistan. Now, the excavations that were made included two rows of six granaries, a single room barrack, a red sandstone male torso, painted pottery, clay figure of Mother Goddess, one of the most important and crucial image that we find throughout the, Indus Valley Civilization. Then a copper scale and a mirror. Last year, in UPSC, the question was asked that we found certain copper scales and mirrors. So To that, yes, we found it, and it was in Harappa. Then a vanity box and a dice, a stone symbol for Lingam and Yoni. Basically, it denotes the Shivalinga. Then a dancing girl. After that, there's a unique characteristic that was seen in Harappa. That is, it is the only city which is evidence of coffin burial. Now, when we come to the part of the burial, we'll see to it that they used to bury their dead. But in Harappa, we find coffins used for burials. Right. Likewise, let's see to it that what these all things were. In front of you is an image of a site in Harappa. Let's visualize the things. The very first image that we are able to see is of the two rows of six granaries. Now, what was the basic purpose of granary? As it is evident that it was utilized for storing the food, right? It is located on the citadel. As per citadel, we have discussed earlier that what it was the basic admin block of every city that was on a mound. Likewise, as I told you, these are six rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and these are total two rows of six granaries that was found in the excavation. The second figure that I'll be showing you will be of a single room barrack, or what kind of barracks were there. So likewise, if we look towards these barracks, we can clearly see that there is a single room with walls on all sides, right, and a smaller, say, kind of a kitchen or something. This was a basic structure that they were utilizing to build up the buildings in the Harappa. Then, talking about pottery, now the pottery, when we come to the culture part, we'll be discussing it in detail, but for now, let me tell you that we found it basically two kinds of potteries. Now, pottery is of two kinds in Harappa. One is painted red and black ware, right? Another one is the plain pottery. So we found many and abundance, as the time goes on, as we have discussed earlier, that the stages of Harappan civilization, we found more references of the red and black wear pottery. So for the same, when we look towards this diagram, basically it is all red and black pottery that we are able to see, and we'll discuss about the pottery later on in the culture part. Then there's an image of a copper scale being utilized. So in these all tools that were utilized, here is the copper scale that they were using. So they did have the scale system. Basically it was in the measurement of 60. The measurements were done on the base of 16, 32 and all. So there's a copper scale also, shows that they were into linear calculations also. Then other important thing that was being asked by the UPSC last year was the mirror. So we do have an image for the mirror. As you can see, this is the museum at Harappa in Pakistan. The image clearly shows you a copper mirror, a lady holding a copper mirror. Then about the dancing girl, so this is a copper statue of a dancing girl. Basically her right hand on her lip, on her hip, sorry, and she's standing in a posture presumed to be she's dancing. Alright, then we also have a dice. This is another point that is very important, that these people, as I will be discussing, that they were the first one to play chess, etc., and games were there. So dice is a good evidence of the same. And when we play, even when we guys play snakes and ladders or Ludo, this kind of a dice is still that we are utilizing to date. So after this, the next important city be the Mohenjo-daro or the Mound of Dead. Mohenjo-daro is another important city excavated in 1922 by Rakhal Das Banerjee or R.D. Banerjee, and it's on the banks of River Indus and is located in Larkana district, Sindh, Punjab. As I told you, it is also known as the Mound of Dead because of the ample amount of the bodies being found. Right, about 41 bodies were found in continuation in one single room. So, and we also have ample amount of places like buried things we find out. It is also known as the Nakhlistan. By the term Nakhlistan, we mean garden. So it was the garden of Harappa. Garden. It's the garden. Right. Coming to the next point, let's discuss about it. There are certain excavations being made. Those excavations include the Great Bath, the Great Granary, bronze statue of Dancing Girl, as was also found in the Harappa. Then there's a multi-pillared assembly hall, a proto-Shiva seal. Then they have a stone statue of a bearded man was found. Clay figure of Mother Goddess, Bricklin, that is the place where the bricks were made. And around about 1398 seals, which account to the total of 57% of total seals that we have till date we have founded of IBC. So Mohenjo-daro being an important with seals, and as we go on we'll learn about seals, that they might have also been used as money. So it also comes out that Mohenjo-daro might be an important center for trade and commerce, right? Then a uniqueness which was here, found here, was they had the first evidences of using button. So we also found out a button over here. So the button that we guys wear in the shirts today is evident came from the Harappan people were known to it. So there is a first evidence of button. And second unique thing was that we also find out two seals of Mesopotamian descent. Likewise, in the very second session, in the very first session indeed, we had the sources of history in which we did coins. And we had, since during this age, seals were utilized as the coins, basically. So we can say if we're finding Mesopotamian seals in IVC, means that some sort of trade was going on. So this is evident of a, say, inter-country state at that time, which was being flourished. Likewise, for the same, let's have an aerial view of Mohenjo-daro, how it looked. So in the figure, let me bifurcate certain things. The area that we see on a mound is the citadel, and rest all is the town being planned around the citadel in a fortified manner. Like, then the next figure into this concludes about the Great Bath. So when we talk about the Great Bath, basically what was its utilization? I hope most of us have seen this movie Mohenjo-daro, and in this movie Great Bath has been shown like a part where cultural activities were taking place, and that is what the presumption of archaeologists is, that all the great cultural activities used to happen here and people used to take bath. Now, a uniqueness of this Great Bath is that they have rooms at every place, at every angle they have a room, mostly for ladies and gents being altogether different, so that they can take a bath over there, they can change over there. Then another important point of this Great Bath was that we have found it bathing areas like these ceremony bathing areas across the Indus Valley civilization, but this is the most biggest Great Bath that we have seen. For an artistic view, how it may have looked like, so as I told you, it had rooms all around itself, and in the movie it has been very much clearly depicted, very nicely depicted. So here we can see are the chambers of the room being provided, entry point to the Great Bath, and here the ceremonies used to take place where the people used to bathe and all. With this information about Great Bath, I'd also talked about a multi-pillared approach, a multi-pillared assembly hall. So here is an example of a multi-pillared assembly hall. Basically, it was an assembly hall where people used to assemble, had round about 6 pillars. So important discussions might have taken place over here. We do not know much about Indus Valley civilization because their language has not been deciphered yet. Right, then we have an example of a seal, the Proto-Siva seal that we found in Mohenjo-daro. Now, the uniqueness of this seal, let me tell you something. It has 4 animals on the top, that is a rhinoceros, a buffalo, an elephant and a tiger. Other than that, there are 2 deers being seated on the foot of the person who is sitting in the yogic posture with 2 horns. Other than that, this yogic man has 3 faces, 2 on the side and 1 is the frontal view that we are able to see. Right, the next image will give you an impression about the bearded man. Now, when it comes to the bearded man, it is taken that this person is wrapped in a cloth with floral settings, as evident. The same for the same reason why it is called a bearded man, because this man has a beard. On his head, we can find certain kind of a ring he has weared, a crown or something like that, but he is into the yogi posture, into the system of the meditation. So he is meditating here, is into a meditating posture. And then the next important figure is of the mother goddess. Now, mother goddess has been found all the way throughout the civilization and is an important deity, a mother of fertilization, we can say, for the same, made using the pinching method, which we'll be discussing later on. Right, after that comes an important city, Chandhudro, which was excavated in 1931 by N.G. Majumdar. Its location is around about 30 kilometers from south from the Mohenjo-daro in Sindh, Pakistan. It is also known as the city without citadel. So this is the only city where we do not find any citadel, and there is a uniqueness about it. But before coming to that point, let's see about what excavations have been made out here. So in the excavation parts, we find out an ink pot, right? A terracotta model of a bullock cart, a lipstick, Now, again, an important question that came last year in the UPSC was like they were known to the fashion and all, lipsticks were utilized or not. Yes, they were known to the fashion, and lipstick is evident over here, made of cinnamon basically. So, coming back, some items were made of bones. Then we also had some seals, and then we had a doll making material. Certain terracotta bangles and beads. So all of these things are also evident towards one thing. So if we come across some seals, doll making material and terracotta medium, it means it was an important, again it was a trade center, an important trade center here. Right. Then coming back to the images, what to have is very clear that the very first image that we have is of the lipstick that they utilize. So it is not the regular lipstick that is being utilized today. It was made of cinnabar. They used to use cinnabar to put the paint over their lips and all these things. So as basically the main utilization might be, one is fashion, of course, another one is the weather conditions. Lipstick gives you a kind of a moisture over your lips, helps to settle them down. Like the second image is of a terracotta model of a bullock cart, again utilized made in punching method. Now what is this punching method? They used to make it through their hands and all. Then is a vanity box or an item being made of some bones, right? Then other doll making material is evident over here. So there are various material being utilized to make the dolls and other toys out of it. Then we found out some seals. Likewise, if you see to the size of the seal, it is 2 by 2 inches, and in this pic it is clearly evident that what kind of what was the basic size of the seals. Then there are certain beads made of terracotta, beads and bangles made of terracotta, which were found at Chan Phutodo. Now basically another important task that I want to tell you, and an important information about Chan Phutodo, it was located on the river Saraswati, which is now extinct, right? Prior to this, it was on the banks of river Saraswati, and secondly, it is also the city without citadels. So the only city without citadel, other cities that we find out in the Harappan civilization are all based on a citadel. They are having a citadel as an administrative center. So here it is a lack of the same. Then comes Roopnagar in Punjab. Roopnagar, presently known as, it is presently known as Roopnagar, right? Excavated in 1953 by Yogdutt Sharma on the banks of river Satluj. Now, of course, it is in Punjab, as I have told you earlier. Not much is known about these ruins. The reason for the same is that only 12 hectares area has been excavated. Only 12 hectares have been excavated over here. Now, I'll come back to a point that I made in the very first session when we were doing about the sources of history. So the area was limited. If you guys remember, I talked about the area of the excavation is limited. So the example for the same being Roopnagar. Now Roopnagar being an area where only 12 hectare place was being a place where only 12 hectare area was excavated, for the same reason that apart from that it is a very settled city, so we cannot excavate much over there, right? So we only have these 12 hectares. Now, an important point about Roopnagar is that it is the first time after the post-impartition, that is after the India got independence, the very first site to be excavated. So this site has the, say, point two associated with it, that it is the very first site excavated after post-partition. Like if they do ask, if any examination pattern, they do ask a question which was the first site to be excavated for the in India after independence, the answers for the same will be the Roopnagar. So without any doubts, we'll click on or mark the answer as Roper. Right, then the excavations at Roper contains beads and bangles of finds, that is shubh karya ke liye pehne jane wale. Cemetery on the Western Mount, that is the W Mount, it has been divided into six periods. Let me tell you this point also, that Roper city, the Roper site is evident for the six periods. Out of those, four are from the Harappan civilization, right? First four parts of the Harappan period. Then we also found some potter's wheel, right? Then some seals, ring wheels, and a wheel. Now coming for the same, I told you that we'll discuss about it. Now here's an example of a terracotta bangles and earrings being made in Roper, which we found out. Then is a site of Roper we are able to see. Then comes up the ring wells. Now when we dug, we found certain wells. We call it ring because as it is clearly evident that these are dug in a sedimentary kind of a thing, like there are rings visible throughout. Then a well that was been excavated, the main center, when you, if you get to Roper and you go to watch it, this is the well that you will be able to see. Then certain pottery, set of pottery was found, which basically comes to the Bara culture, right? And certain seals and scales that were found were in Roper. Coming to the next point being Bara, another important site associated with Roper itself. Talking about Bara, it is near Roper, Punjab, evident of delaying culture of pre-Harappan era. Now Bara is also known for the Bara culture, that is wheel turned pottery. Now till now what we have seen is a pinching method being utilized in Harappan civilization, but here is an example of a wheel turned pottery, the same which is being utilized today. Mostly pottery had larger bowls with bulge convex shapes, and bones of animals like rhino, elephant, etc. was found. So let's look forward towards the images. Very first image about the pottery. Now I told you it is a bulging shape, a concave shape. So here is an example of a Bara pottery, right? Then certain pottery that we found in Bara, these all into some smaller pieces we found. Then comes a perforated pottery, a unique pottery that we found out throughout the civilization is a perforated pottery. In this, the pottery we can see there are the straining pinches been made. Basically, we believe that it was utilized for straining liquor. Then another example for the Bara is the dish box with a plate on the top is a unique example. Then a perforated pottery, and most of the pottery that we look forward is in a bulging shape. So this all, this kind of pottery was given the name of Bara culture, right? And finally we have the images of certain bones being found at Bara. Now these all images, these all things can be found out at the Roper Museum. After this comes an important city of Lothal, a dockyard, so called an artificial dockyard. I'll be more concise about it. It's an artificial dockyard. They have an artificial dockyard. I'll show you the images for the same, how it looks like and why do we call it artificial dockyard, it will be evident. Excavated in 1957 by S.R. Rao on the banks of river Bhogwa in Ahmedabad, Gujarat. Right. Then the excavations that were made, we found a brick dockyard that was a man-made dockyard, of course, since bricks were found. Then fire altars, rice rusk, that means an evidence of paddy culture. The first evidence of paddy was found in Lothal. Then modern day chest was found, a grinding machine tool was found. Then a terracotta model of a ship and a horse. Granary was again found over here. Redware pottery, that is the same red and blackware pottery. Now instruments to measure 180 degree, 90 and 45 degree angles, and a tusk of an elephant and a couch sill workshop was found. There is a uniqueness to this that the city was divided into six sectors, right? And each was built on a wide platform with a unique brick, right? So the lower town had massive brick walls, and the house's entrance was on the main street. So here's an image of the Lothal, an artistic view being given about. So you can see the dockyard being on the banks of the river in Lothal. It's a totally man-made dockyard. And as I was telling you about, the city was divided into six sectors, right? These each built was a wide platform with a under brick. So they were each on a wide platform made by using unripped bricks, right? Coming on to the images associated with Lothal, so the very first image will be of the wells of the Lothal dockyard that we are able to see. So clearly it is a dockyard been made out of bricks, and then is a terracotta image of a horse, a terracotta model of ship been made. These both models have been used, unlike the Bara culture, these have been made using the pinching method, the same method being utilized for making mother goddess, and thus they used to make it through their hands. So perfection is a problem over here. Then we have a council. Now the council in today's time period also shankh har ghar mein hota hai, right? So this is the same place they used to have a workshop where they used to get the shells out, and most probably they were also working for the pearls and all. Likewise, when it comes to the other image, we can see the modern day chess. I told you that we found out the modern day chess, so there is an example of the modern day chess. If any question do comes that was chess known to the Indus Valley civilization people, yes, it was known. So for the same, the example has been put forward towards you. It's a chess which was utilized by the Indus Valley people, right? And then there is a painted red and black pottery which we'll be discussing later on, but for the initial let me tell you why it is called painted red and black ware. It's a reason that if we look towards the background of the same pottery is black, red, and the black color has been utilized with geometric figures or certain animal motifs, and people was utilized to be made. So doing this, it was afterwards it was polished, right? It was very much clear that might have been utilized for decorative pieces purposes. Now coming back to Banwali and Kalibangam is the next site that we'll be looking forward. Both of these are the pre-Harappan sites, and excavations were made in for Banwali in 1974 by R.S. Bhisht. R.S. Bhisht at that time was the Director General of Archaeological Survey of India, and it is on the banks of river Ghaggar in Haryana. Kalibangam, for the same, it was excavated in 1959 by B.B. Lat on the banks of again river Ghaggar, but this time in Rajasthan. As I told you that these both sites were the pre-Harappan sites. Why do we call so? Because there are certain aspects being missing, like there is no drainage system, and other things are also evident. So what were the excavations being made over in these two sites? What do we find? Now we find out decorated bricks, bangles, then we find bones of camel, tiled floor, pawed fields, evident of farming and agriculture, then the wheel of a toy car, black bangles, breed of barley, multi-roomed houses having kitchens and toilets attached, several seals and certain weights which we'll see are into measures of 16, there are multiple of 16s, right? So the uniqueness in Kalibangam is that the figurine of mother goddess is absent. We were talking about the point that mother goddess has been found in every part of the Harappan civilization, but it is the only place where we do not find the evidence of mother goddess. It has not been excavated till now. henceforth we say that is our pre-Harappan era. Then a uniqueness point also being that there are wells found at the every house. In the other cities that we find out, the wells were common to the people, but here in Kalibangan we have a well for every house. Then there is massive brick walls around the citadel on the lower town, which is another uniqueness, because in other cities that we find in Harappa, either the fortification has been made around the entire city or has not been made at all. But this is the only place evident of a dual brick wall around the citadel as well as the lower town. So coming to the wells, as I told you, so here's an example of the well at every house. So every house used to have a well for their own purposes. Then we have an example of a toy cart wheel, which is again clearly evident made up from the pinching method. Then there are the bangles. For the same, the name was given Kalibangan on the name of the bangles, because bangles which were found were black. Here is an image for the weight and measures being used. Now the weight and measures being used were basically, the shape was either cuboid or cubical. Not like today's that we see at most of the place. Now that thing is also going away since digital meters have came. And then there is a side of a tilted floor, tiled floor to be very precise. They used to decorate their houses, like you can easily see that the floor has been tiled out. And then is an image of a site and excavation multi-room chamber. So in this, likewise, when we saw for Harappa, there was only one single room barrack. So there's a bathroom being attached, and there's a other rooms being attached to it and a kitchen. So bathroom is opening up to the place where the drainage system must be there. And they also, at certain places, we do not find a drainage system at these places. So henceforth, this is like a pre-Harappan site which was never been made prior. Next, coming on to Rangpur, excavated in 1931 by MS Watts on the banks of River Bahadur in Kathiawad district of Gujarat. Now the city of Rangpur is very important, as the excavations being made, we find on the second evidence of rice rusks were found. Prior to this, we found this the same in Lothal. Prior to this, we found the same in the Lothal area. Then terracotta model of ship was found again. So for the same, let's see certain figures like terracotta model of ship is in front of you. Then there is an evidence of double burial. Now when it comes to the term double burial, we must understand what it is. For the same, I'll be talking about double burial later on also in the culture part. But prior to this, let me just give you a brief introduction about it. Basically, what they used to do is that they used to bury two people in one grave. Suppose there's a couple, a husband and a wife. Whoever dies earlier will be buried, and when the counterpart of the same dies, will be buried again into the same grave, with holding hands and all sort of things will be done. So this was an evidence, we find out of evidence of a double burial. Coming to the double burial site, so here as we can see, the burial has been made along with the belongings also. The belongings are also, then there is painted red and black pottery that we have already seen prior to this. The next site, important site, is Dholavira, excavated in 1990 by again RS, based on the banks of river Luni in Gujarat. Right. Basically, one of the five largest sites that we have been able to find out in the Harappan civilization. Excavations here contain a giant water reservoir, water harnessing system, a dam and embankments, a stadium, a signboard with Indus script, and a rock cut architecture was also found. So in this, the signboard with Indus script is a unique pattern, because we have not found out any signboard. So let's look forward and don't think about that this signboard is similar that we see today. It's a quite bit different. The uniqueness in this is that it's the only city to be divided into three parts, that is, it had three citadels. So earlier also I was telling you that the city is contained one citadel. This is the only city in Dholavira which has three administrative setups, three citadels associated with it. For the same, let's look forward towards the site. So here it is, the very first citadel has been, we can look forward. Then is the stadium. It is the only site where we find out the stadium. So it is the only site with a stadium also. So if the question comes that where do we find the stadium in IBC, the only site is Dholavira. Like, then coming on to the next image, that would be the Indus writing board, Indus script, the signboard with Indus script. So I told you that it's not an signboard that we utilize. Basically it is the road, and on the road with Indus script they have inscribed. Mostly it might have given the way for the stadium itself. So since we do not know the script, we cannot say what it is written, but evidently it is close to the stadium. So we can take part that is the way point been given that the stadium is on the this side. Next important city is the, that we'll see to it, that other cities, the important cities which are to be discussed but not that much important, we'll look forward towards them. For that, the same, very first is Ali Murad in Pakistan. There is a big fort been found in Pakistan. Then there is Kot Diji, again in Pakistan on the river Bhogwa. This city has an evidence that it was destroyed by force or certain fire, because most of the things, most of the excavated part contains tar. So since tar is there, tar only comes through if their place has been put on fire. So this city might have faced some fearsome fire, or say by force or by natural calamity or something like that, but this entire city was burned down to ground zero. Then is Surkotara in Bhuj area of Gujarat. Now Surkotara, here we have two fold divisions of the town, citadel and city. Now another unique point is two fold divisions of a town, citadel and city, is that basically the city was all around the citadel, not same for the same city. Then is Sutka Gindor, 55 kilometers away from the Arabian Sea on the banks of river Tash near Iran-Pakistan border, right, and was the westernmost border of the IBC. Then the next site that we need to know is Alamgirpur, excavated in 1974 by Yogdutt Sharma on the banks of river Hindon, Meerut, UP. And for the same, it is also the eastmost border for the IBC. Then is Amiri, actual remains of rhinoceros were found, full remains. Talking about the recent discoveries, we have Rakhi Ghadi in Hisar district by Rafiq Mughal, a Pakistani excavator. Then Ganviriwala in Pakistan, again by Rafiq Mughal. Dholavira, that we have discussed early, in Gujarat, excavated by R.S. Bhest, and is the largest and the latest site in India. So other than that, in India we also found out Birhana, that is the oldest Arapan site been found in the Fatehabad district of Haryana. That will be all for today. I hope you like this session, and the next session we'll be talking about the religious aspects and other aspects related to the Harappan civilization.